Right, sir. Let us recall what we discussed yesterday. Yesterday we have chance to start our BMM layer. BMM layer. BMM layer is the main layer in the RPD. Even though we have the physical layer, presentation layer, most of the work we are going to do in the BMM layer. So BMM layer is the main layer in the RPD development. In that BMM layer, we are going to create one thing that is called as business models. A business model is nothing but a subject area or a data mart. A business area. In BMM layer, all we are going to use business terminology. That is the reason it is also known as business layer. And also it is known as logical layer. We are going to use all the terminologies, logical terminology. For example, whatever ACTL, EXTND column is available, that one we are converting into the dollars and we are using it. Okay, that's what it is called as logical layer. In the development of BMM layer, in a basic level, we have 5 steps. Number 1 is called as creating business models. Number 2 is called as creating logical tables and logical columns. Number 3 is called as creating logical joins. Then renaming the objects whatever available. 5th one is creating the measures. Yesterday we have chance to complete how to create the business model. Then we went for how to create the logical tables and logical columns. And third one we went very important one, what is logical join? Why we need to create logical join? Even though we have the physical layer, physical join is available, why you are going for logical join? What are the different advantages are available in the logical join? Those all points yesterday we have chance to discuss it. That is what the main topic what yesterday went. Okay, now today we need to understand what even we are renaming columns. Renaming columns. Next point, step 4, renaming columns. If I open my RPD, all the columns are available as a capital letters like this, right? What is my requirement is, first letter I want as a capital, remaining all letters I want in the small case. If I change one by one, it's going to take longer time. To overcome that kind of problem, what you need to do is, you need to go to the tools menu. There I have one option that is called as utilities. In the utilities, one of the wizard is available. That wizard is known as rename wizard. If I select this rename wizard, click on execute, then it is asking presentation layers and business model mapping layer. 2 layers are available. That means we can rename only objects of BMM layer and presentation layer only. If you rename objects of physical layer, is it going to be valid or not valid, sir? Not valid. That's what we are not going to rename anything in the physical layer. Suppose if, for example, we are renaming one table name as something else we are renaming, that day onwards it won't work because this table is not available in the database. It's saying as table or view does not exist. That means you should not change the table name of the physical layer or column name of the physical layer. You can change only table names and column names as you like in the BMM layer or presentation layer, BMM layer or presentation layer. That's what even our wizard also designed in such a way, it allows you to create only renaming in the BMM layer or presentation layer only we can create it. Now in the BMM layer, you want to rename only one column, you want to rename, or you want to rename one table, or you want to rename entire business model, all the objects you want to rename. So you need to select your topmost object that is called as business model. Biggest object that is called as business model. Then click on here, add hierarchy. Whenever you click on add hierarchy, entire business model is coming here. Then click on next. Then you can see here, as part of this one, business model name is going to change. Logical table name is going to change. Logical table source folder name changing. Logical table source changing. Logical column also changing. Click on the next. Then you can observe different options are available. Different rules are available. I can say these are things that is called as different rules. Based on what rule you want to rename the things. I want to rename the things based on first letter. What do you want, sir? First letter you want capital. So I am adding that first letter as capital. And change each occurrence of underscore into a space. Wherever underscore is available, that one I want to change as a space. Down the line, if you have any other characters are available, those characters you want to change it. Let us say, wherever we have, let us say, ID, wherever we have ID, that ID you want to change as, let us say, number. That's what your requirement. Wherever we have the ID, that one you want to change as what, sir? Number. That's what your requirement. At that moment, yes, you can go and add that rule also. Change each occurrence of ID into what, sir? Number. That means you can write here customized rules also, you can write it. Customized rules also, you can write it. As of now, I don't want that one, I am removing it. Let us click on next. You can observe here one of the thing. Let us say, observe this one. Package underscore weight will be renamed as package space weight. And in that one, P is capital, remaining all letters are small letters. That means you are able to convert uppercase into lowercase or not, sir? Actually, strictly speaking, we are converting init cap. That means what, sir? Initial capital we are trying to convert. Now, click on finish. Then we are able to observe all the columns and tables, everything renamed here. Now, you people understand how the things are happening here using renaming wizard. Now, that point is very clear. Let us move on to the next one that is called as defining measures. What do you mean by defining measures? Why I need to learn this step is, let us go and observe here one report, sir. I am trying to develop one report. This is someone batch RPD. This is not your RPD. Let us say I am opening browser. There I am trying to develop one report. New analysis, supplier sales. I am taking one column called as year column. Second column called as dollars column I am taking. Click on the results. Whenever I clicked on the results, I got some number here. Tell me, this number is stored in this way only in the database or in the runtime it is did some aggregation and all? In the runtime it applied some aggregation rule that is called as sum. Yes or no, sir? Now, where you applied that one? It is sum function, where you applied it? In the RPD already we applied that one. That is what it is happening. Suppose if I click on the 1998, it is automatically roll upping the data as for what, sir? Months. If I click on the April, it automatically roll up in the data as per day. What I mean to tell is, because of the backend aggregation rule, automatically it is roll upping. That means whatever measure columns are available, we need to identify those measure columns. Then we need to apply the sum function or aggregate function or average or min, max, count, whatever you want as per the requirement, you can apply it. Now, each and every measure should associate with one aggregation rule. This is a mandatory rule. If I say a column as measure column, that must be associated with one aggregation rule. Okay, let us say I have here table source data is available like this. Some example I am trying to provide here. To explain that example, I am opening MS Excel. Then, this is what my source data. This is what my source data. This is what my source data. Now, if I am doing this report, I am developing, which is more easy to end user and which is applied the measure column aggregation rule, sir. If I say without applying aggregation rule, if I drag and drop department number salary into my reporting end, then there is no automatic aggregation will happen. Because of that one, all we are getting what, sir? Detailed records we are getting. So this one is examples for we didn't automatically aggregating here. We are not automatically aggregating here. Whereas this one, we are trying to do automatic aggregation. Whenever one aggregation rule is associated with one number column, a number column is associated with one aggregation rule, then it is called as measure column. Fine. In my case, already people are aware of it. We have here columns. The column is known as dollars column. Dollars column is a measure column or not, sir? It's a measure column. It talks about the money, how much money we got. If I ask end of the day, in this year, what is the total revenue I received? Or in this region, what is the total money I received? Okay, like that, if I ask questions, then I need to sum up the things. If I want to sum up the things, I need to apply your aggregation rule. How we can apply the aggregation rule? Let me give control to someone so that they can get some experience also while I'm explaining. Yes. Satish, I am giving control to you. I gave control. Satish, double click on dollars. Double click on dollars. Then we can see one tab. The tab is known as aggregation tab. One tab is known as aggregation tab. Click on aggregation tab. Click on aggregation tab. General tab, column source. Beside that, aggregation tab is available. Click on that. Satish, quickly. Click on aggregation tab. Any problem? Okay. Now apply the default aggregation rule as sum. See here, these are the different aggregation rules which are available. Different aggregation rules which are available. Okay, you can apply. Most of the times we are going to apply sum. Of course, there are some scenarios you may use average, count, these things also you may use it. But most of the using function is what, sir? Sum is the one thing what you're going to use it. Let us say I have a column called as employee number. I want to know count of employees in my organization. At that moment, what I am going to do, sir? Employee number column rule I will take and I apply the aggregation rule as count so that I will get the count of employees. Okay. Right. Let us say you want to know the minimum salary of the minimum salary in my organization, what I am paying. At that moment, I can go and I can apply min. Tomorrow, I want to know department wise minimum salaries I want to know. Then I can drag and drop department number and I can drag and drop minimum salary column, whatever available, then I can drag and drop it. That means what I would like to say is, yes, we are going to use some other functions also as per the requirement, as per the requirement. But as of now, we are going for what, sir? Some we are going. Now click on, sorry, some we are going. Now click on OK. Click on OK. Right. Similarly, I want to aggregate this column and this column also. If you want to do more than one column at a time, you can select all the three columns at a time. Using control, you can select it. Using control, you can select all three columns, then right click. Right click. There I have an option. That option is known as set aggregation, bottom option. Set aggregation. Then provide here default aggregation rule as sum. Default aggregation rule as sum. Click on OK. Click on OK. Now I am giving one exercise to you people, sir. What is exercise is, double click on this dollars column. If you go and see, I have here something called as first and last is available, right? Yes or no? First and last is available. What you mean by first? What you mean by last? I want by tomorrow. The remaining all things, people are aware of it. Yes or no? I think first and last are the two things which are not aware of it. Okay, what is the first and last values? You need to understand where you can get the answer is, if you click on this help document, if you click on the wherever you want help, if you click on that one, then you can search here. You can search here. Basing, enabling, creating, setting default, level of aggregation for measure columns, count, district. Okay, he is given one example how to set the aggregation rule. First and last also you can search and you can get it. If it is not available here also, at least you can go for the Google and try to get that one. What do you mean by first and what do you mean by last values? Okay, if you say that first means first value means, what is the first value? Is it a minimum value or maximum value? Then min and max also available, right? Min and max also available. Then what is the difference between min and max and first and last? Okay, this is what the Google it and try to get the answers. Even if you go and read this appendix, whatever available in somewhere, you may have that one. Math functions, string functions, about logical SQLs. Then go for aggregate and running aggregate functions. Yes. Here I have what, sir? First function. First function means what it is trying to explain. Okay. Now try to get this, fully read this one. And bottom we have the syntax also and example also available. What is the meaning of that one you come to understand? Can you do this groundwork or not, sir?
Yes.
Let us move on to the next one. I am trying to click on OK as of now. With this, I completed creating. What, sir? Measure columns. Next, I have some notes are available. The notes will discuss one by one. First point is available that is called as one business model may map to multiple databases. Instead of going directly from here, why can't I can go with the PowerPoint? I want to open the PowerPoint. Let us go for practitioner level presentations. Let us say business model and mapping layer. Right. Objective of this lesson is identify the objects in the business model and mapping layer of a repository. Now tell me, are you in a position to identify what are the objects are available in the BMM layer or not, sir? We know what is this object. What is object, sir? Business model. What is this object, sir? Logical table. Inside the logical table, whatever available, that is what, sir? Logical table source. And we have here column. This is logical column. These logical columns are again divided into three types. One is key column, string column, then measure columns. Now, next point. Build a business model. Yes, we have chance to create one business model. Third one, create measures in business model, that also we have chance to understand. Then, business model and mapping layer. The BMM layer is where physical schemas are simplified and reorganized to form the basis. Basis means what, sir? The foundation of the user's view of the data. Whatever way user is thinking about that data, in that way we are trying to rename the things. So that we are going to give some kind of fundamental basis for the business user understanding. Whatever a business user used to call the terms, in that way we are trying to rename our technical terminology into business terminology. That's what we are saying as basis of the user's view of the data. Whatever a user will view the data, in the same way we are trying to convert it. Right, that's what the business model and mapping layer. Let us move on to the next one. In the business model and mapping layer, we have these are the objects. First object is called as business model. This is what the business model is available. Next, as of now, I didn't get chance to cover this dimensional hierarchies. One more object is available, dimensional hierarchies. This hierarchies I will cover down the line in the hierarchy chapter. Now, let us move on to the next one. This is logical dimension table. This is logical fact table. This is logical data source, logical column. Logical column is also divided into what, sir? Measures, keys, and strings. Same thing you can call it as logical column. Same thing you can call it as measure column also. Right. Let us move on to the next one. Business model mapping. Now, BMM layer objects map to source data objects in the physical layer. Any object you take in the BMM layer that is directly or indirectly mapped with what, sir? Physical layer. From yesterday, you are doing lot of hard work you are doing, right? I can do in this way also. See here. Simply blindly, I am trying to select a supplier to whatever available and I am trying to drag and drop like this. Whenever you drag and drop like this, whatever schema name is available, the schema name is appearing as what, sir? Business model name. Whatever physical table name is available, that is appearing as what, sir? Logical table name. And whatever physical column is available, that is appearing as what, sir? Logical column name. Okay, and also you need to notice, whenever you blindly drag and drop, whatever physical joints are available here, based on the physical joints, automatically it is created what, sir? Logical joints also it is created automatically. If you want, you can go and you can observe here, business model diagram, then whole diagram. Then you can observe here, this automatically created what, sir? Logical joint. So, simply you can drag and drop, entire schema you can drag and drop into the BMM layer. But as a best practice, we are not recommending drag and drop. Why? Because all unnecessary columns also coming here, your business model becomes somewhat huge. I don't want to make somewhat huge your business model. Whatever really required the columns, those things only try to move into the BMM layer. Am I clear? Now, what I would like to say is, these terms you need to understand. Whatever business model is available, the business model is equivalent to what, sir? Schema name. And whatever logical table is available, that is equivalent to what, sir? Physical table name. Whatever logical column is available, that is equivalent to what, sir? Physical column name. That's what I want to understand. Next, business models map to multiple databases. What is the meaning of this one? What is the meaning of this one? Business models may map to multiple data sources. What is the meaning is, let us say I am going to the reporting end. Sorry, I am going to the RPD. I am deleting the supplier 2. Then, I want here MS Excel corresponding data also I want. Can I take it or not, sir? You can take it. Let us say I am going for the file menu, then import metadata, and you know already ODBC connection is yours corresponding B201 MS Excel. Then I am clicking on next, then click on this one, click on finish. Then you can observe here we have this one. Let us say I am trying to drag and drop products here. Now tell me here one point, whatever products is available, this product is coming from where, sir? MS Excel database. These all things are coming from where, sir? Oracle database. That means under one business model, you may have a number of databases corresponding things or not. Yes, possible. You may have it. Let me show you one previous batch RPD so that you get some kind of scenario. I am going to the previous batch RPD, BA administration, open this one, sorry. Open, then your previous batch RPD is B198 batch and I am taking whatever latest version is available, that latest version I am taking. RPD, open, then RR capital, I take small, 1, 2, 3. Now observe here carefully, I have here, this is what, sir? Targets data. This targets data contains, this is what it contains, we have here, quotes are available here. Item type and what is the targets are available. And actually in this ORCL, we have some tables. In that table, one of the table is D1 order 2. There I have what, sir? Actuals are available. But somehow I want actuals and targets both I want to integrate here. Then what you did is, if you go and observe here, I have what, sir? Reason type quota, whatever available. Reason type quota added as a one more LTS. D1 orders added as what, sir? One LTS. Finally, we are seeing in this one, targets we are seeing. Then what are you seeing, sir? Dollars we are seeing. Dollars is coming from where? Oracle database. Targets are coming from where? MS Excel database. Tomorrow if I want to develop a report, year wise what are the dollars, what are the targets, I can generate that report. So overall what I want you to understand is, under one business model, I have objects which are coming from multiple databases or not? I have objects which are coming from multiple databases. What are the scenarios you come to understand down the line? As of now, that is possible or not, you need to understand. That is possible. That's what I given one point here. Business model may map to multiple databases or data sources. Next point. Logical models may map to multiple physical tables. One logical table may map to multiple physical tables. That one you come to understand very clearly. See this one. This is a logical table or not, sir? This logical table is depending on what are the physical tables. These all three physical tables is depending. Even if you want, right click on the logical table. There I have query related objects. Related objects is nothing but dependencies. Yes or no, sir? Dependencies of what you want, sir? You want physical table. That means this logical table is depending on what are the physical tables I want to understand. If I click on that one, then it is giving here D1 order 2, order AZZ1, region quota, it is depending. Even if you want to see those all things at a time, you can select these all things, click on go to. Then it is selected or not, sir? Region type quota, D1 order AZZ1, D1 order 2, these all three things are useful for this one. Other words, I can say the sales facts is depending on this one, and also it is depending on this one, it is also depending on this one. So, one logical table may be mapped with a number of physical tables or not, sir? One logical table may be mapped with a number of physical tables. Let us move on to the next one. One logical column also may be mapped with multiple physical columns. What is the meaning of that one? One logical column may be mapped with multiple physical columns. For example, if you go and see here, I have here a column called as dollars column. If you go and right click on this dollars column, then go to the query related objects, then I have here physical columns. If I click on this physical column, then how many columns it is depending, sir? two columns which are coming from what are the tables. Click on go to, then you come to understand it is coming from D1 order AGG1 and also it is coming from D1 order 2 table. So one logical column may be depending on, multiple physical columns or not. One logical column may be depending on multiple physical columns. Okay, if you go and see here also D1 order 2, go to the column mapping, it is saying as ACTL EXJND column is coming from what table, sir? D1 order 2 table. Suppose if you go for this one, ACTL EXJND column, which is coming from what, sir? D1 order AGG1. D1 order AGG1. So what I would like to say this one actually. Dollars is coming from where, sir? D1 order 2. Same dollars is coming from where, sir? D1 order AGG1. That means same column is mapped with multiple physical columns which are coming from multiple physical tables or not. Why we are going for this is to improve the performance. That performance related activities I will tell later point of time. As of now, one logical column may be mapped with n number of physical columns. That is possible. That's what I am saying. Logical columns may map to multiple physical columns. Right. Simply what I want to say is this one. So BMM layer to physical layer, what type of mapping, sir? It is one to many mapping. BMM layer to physical layer, always what type of mapping is going on? One to many mapping is going on. Okay, that point is very clear. Now business model and mapping layer objects, everyone knows it. What is the business model and logical table? Logical table sources, logical columns, logical primary keys, logical joins, measures and renaming the BMML objects, these all points we are aware of it. First, let us go and try to understand what you mean by business model. Anyone ask a question, what is a business model? Business model is the highest level object in the BMM layer. What is the highest level object in the physical layer, sir? Database. What is the highest level object in the BMM layer? Business model. What is the highest level object in the presentation layer? Subject area. So here it is called as database. Here it is called as business model. Here it is called as subject area. The biggest object is here business model. Right. Next, contains the business model definitions and the mappings from logical to physical tables. Yes, I know, sir. Each and every logical table directly or indirectly related to what, sir? N number of physical tables. Next, simplifies the physical schema. What is the meaning of that one? For example, I have under ORCL, I have finance data is available, sales data is available. Then what I can do, sir? I can create here sales, one business model I can create, sales relevant tables I can drag and drop here. I can create one more business model, I can give the name as finance, and finance relevant tables I can drag and drop here. So can I simplify the business models or not, sir? Whatever physical database available, that one we are going to simplify using n number of business models. That's what I mean to tell here. Next one. Capture how users think about their business using their own vocabulary. Is interested to call the dollars. That is the reason we converted ACTL EXTND into what, sir? We converted into the dollars. That means whatever a business vocabulary, business like to call that one. In that way, we are trying to convert the terminology. So business terminology, we are trying to modify in the BMM layer. In a business terminology, we are modifying the BMM layer, all the objects. It may be logical objects or it may be physical objects, anything. Let us go for the next one, that is called as logical tables. How many types of logical tables are available, sir? See the slide and tell me. That's correct. Only two things are available. Very high level this is. Again, this fact table is maybe divided into some other things, factless, fact table, okay, and also we have let us say aggregate fact table, okay, detailed fact table, like the n number of things are available. but end of the day, high level what, sir? Fact table. This is called as dimension table. Of course, internally dimension tables are also divided into n number of types, like chunk dimension, okay, conformed dimension, like the n number of things are available. But end of the day, high level what, sir? Two types of tables are available. One is called as fact table. Second is called as dimension table. Now, can be created automatically by dragging tables from physical layer. Next, manually by right-clicking business model and selecting new object logical table. Yesterday we implemented this one only. Yes or no, sir? And if you want to drag and drop a table also, can you drag and drop or not? You can drag and drop, and that also I shown today morning. Can be modified without affecting physical layer objects. Suppose if I rename this one, anything renaming is happening in the physical layer? No, right? So whatever renaming I am doing in the BMM layer, that is not changing any object in the physical layer. Next one, logical table sources. Logical table source means already people are aware of it. Defines the mapping from logical table to physical table. Tell me, by seeing this one, if I ask a question, this table is depending on what physical table? How you come to understand, sir? Simple question I asked here. This table is depending on what physical table? Based on that name you are going to understand, that name also I am going to change here. I am changing that also. It won't throw any error. I can change that also. Now tell me how you come to understand this fact sales is depending on what table? Right click and go for the query related object. That is one way. I don't want to use that option. Then what way you can do it? If you double click on logical table source, logical table source, that is source folder, logical table source. Then we have the general tab. Then observe here. What you are observing, sir? This is coming from, this logical table source is coming from where, sir? From VRCL database, from supply to schema, from D1 order to table. Now we come to understand exactly physical table, what is that? Using this terminology or not? That means one logical table is depending on what physical table means, that information is available inside the LTS. Yes or no, sir? Inside the LTS, we have the relationship between logical table and physical table based on what table you understand. You got my point? Okay. Now, LTS is a mediator. LTS is a mediator between physical tables and what, sir? Logical table. Physical table and logical table. That's what I mean to tell here. Next, logical tables may have multiple logical table sources. Correct or not, sir? One logical table may have multiple logical table sources. If you go and observe this slide, this one, if you observe here, this is my logical table. Under this logical table, how many logical table sources are available? N number of logical table sources are available. Okay, right. This is aggregate table. This is detailed table. This contains the target's data. So n number of things are available. Next, one logical table source may map to many what, sir? Physical sources. Observe this one. Let us say I have your products. Under products, I have D1 products is available. If I double click on D1 products, go to the general tab. This logical table source, whatever available, contains how many physical tables, sir? N number of physical tables. That means one logical table source may be mapped with N number of physical tables or not? N number of physical tables. Okay, that point is very clear. Let us say I am trying to click on OK. Next one. Logical table source column mappings. Click the column mapping tab in logical table source dialog box to build, view or modify logical to physical column mappings. Suppose I have here column mappings are available. Okay, if you go and see here, logical column is what and physical column is what, from where it is coming, those all things you come to understand by seeing column mapping only or not, sir? That's what we are saying, logical table source, column mapping. Click the column mapping tab in logical table source dialog box to build, view or modify. Suppose you think like don't want to map dollars column equal to ACTLEXT and you want to map something else. You can map like that. I mean to say, what is the problem is, let us say I have dollars. As of now, dollars is mapped with, what is the column backend, sir? ACTL, EXTND. I want to change this one. How I can change it? Double click on this logical table source. Then go to the column mapping. This is what the dollars column. Expression is what, sir? ACTL, EXTND. That one I want to change into something else. Can I change it or not? That means, one logical column, at any point of time, you can go ahead and you can change that one whatever way you want it. Even you want to do some kind of big calculation, you want to do it. Then click on here, edit expression button. Then you can write here whatever code you want to write here, you can write it the code. Using whatever function you want to write the code, that code you can write and you can derive that one. That means, what I mean to tell from this is, you can see it, you can modify it. Build, view, or modify. Let us move on to the next one that is called as logical columns. Logical columns may map to many columns in the physical layer. That is possible or not, sir? Previously I shown dollars column. Dollars column is mapped with the D1 order AGZ1 table as well as D1 order 2 table. Before going for that one, some question. What is the question? Sir, what is the difference between having multiple logical table sources and one logical table source mapping to multiple tables? Okay, this question you come to understand more clearly in the chapter that is called as adding multiple sources, sir. If you go and see your notes, next answer 5 is available, adding multiple sources. There I am going to explain, okay, how to add the to LTS or LT, these all things are going to understand at that moment. Okay, here I am going to explain those all things. As of now, park that side. Right, let us go for the logical columns. May map to many columns in the physical layer. What is the meaning, sir? Suppose previously I shown one column, that column is called as dollars column. That dollars column may be mapped with this dollars column whatever available, not your RPD. This dollars column whatever available here, that is mapped with what, sir? If you go and get the related objects, then it is coming from two things. One is called as D1 order AGZ1. Second thing is called as D1 orders 2. Two tables, two columns, it is coming. Next point. May be defined by other logical columns also. Possible or not, sir? If you go and see here, let us say, I have here pending orders. Pending orders is coming from unit ordered as well as unit shipped. If you go internally and see here, we have here B201 sales, fact sales, then unit ordered minus B201 sales, fact sales and unit shipped. These two things if you subtract, then we are getting here pending orders. So this pending orders column is depending on two logical columns or not. Two logical columns, it is depending. Okay, next point. Can be created automatically by dragging tables or columns from the physical layer. That is possible. Just simply we can drag and drop the columns. Or manually also can create by right clicking a logical table and selecting new object logical column. In this way only we created the pending orders column. Yes or no? Yesterday we created pending orders column by using second method. Remaining all columns we implemented using first method. Now logical primary keys. This is important slide, sir. It is important slide. Define unique identifiers for logical table. This is what the unique identifier here. It is a primary key column. Now define the lowest level of detail of a logical table. Always remember, whatever column we are defining the primary key, that is the lowest column actually. Yes or no, sir? Whatever you are defining primary key column, that is a lowest column. That is a least level column. Now, are required for each logical dimension table for valid repository. If I, let us say, for one dimension table, you don't have a primary key, then our system is going to throw error. For example, simply I am dragging and dropping this one here. I drag and drop into the presentation layer. Then I am going to the file menu, check global consistency. That means we are testing our RPD, it's correct or not. It's saying as you checked everything and saying as B201 sales is consistent. Do you want to mark it as available for queries? Click on yes. Click on close. There is no errors are available, only warning is available. Click on close. Now this is turned into what, sir? Green color. Previously it is available, some kind of red color is available. Red symbol is available. Now what I want to tell is, let us say if I go and if I see your periods table, I have what, sir? I have key, primary key column is available. If you go and select the customers table, I have what, sir? I have primary key column is available. If I go and select your products table, I have what, sir? I have primary key column is available. What I would like to say is I have here primary key column for each and every dimension, but don't have what, sir? The fact table is not available. Even fact table is not required also. Okay, dimension table, it is required, it is mandatory. For example, suppose I am making this column as a normal column. How to make like that? Double click on your logical table, then go to the keys tab. There, this is acting as a primary key. Day key corresponding logical name is, this is the logical name. This is acting as what, sir? Primary key. Suppose I am selecting this one, delete it. Yes. Okay. Now day key column still available, but it is not acting as what, sir? Primary key. Now with this, if I go for the file menu, check global consistency, it is saying as what, sir? Is not consistent. Click on yes, then you can observe here error. Error with the problem is business model, and this was the object, error number is this one, and error description is this one. Okay, now I am trying to click on close. Now if people understand one point very clearly, in each and every dimension table, you must have what, sir? Primary key. Primary key is not available, it is going to throw the error. Now I am double clicking on this one. How to create the primary key is very simple. We are saying as it is a time key. And our column we need to map for this logical column. I am mapping as day key. This one I am selecting as primary key. Click on OK. Now if I go for the file menu, check global consistency, we are able to see no errors. Okay. That's what the meaning of third point. Are required for each logical dimension table for valid repository. Let us move on to the next one, that is called as logical joins. Yesterday, almost our class time we spend on this only. Okay, logical join express the cardinality relationship between logical tables and are required for valid business model. Correct or not, sir? Without logical join, our business model also invalid, sir. I mean to say, if I right click on this one, business model diagram, whole diagram, I have what, sir? All the things are logical joins are available. That is the reason if I go for the check global consistency, it's showing no errors. Now, if I delete one of the thing, let us say I'm deleting this join. Now, if I go for the file menu, check global consistency, it's saying as what, sir? Not consistent. Click on yes. What is the problem is error. Error is what, sir? The logical table B201 sales dim customers is not joined to any other logical tables. That is a problem. If I create the logical join here, let us say I created here, then go to the file menu, check global consistency. Is it throwing any error? No. What is your understanding from this? If you want to make your model correct, then I require what, sir? Mandatorily, I require logical join. Express the cardinality, that is okay. Help Oracle PA Server to understand the relationship between various objects of the business model. Examining logical join is integral part of how Oracle PA Server figures out how to construct the physical queries. Did you learn yesterday or not? Fifth point. First advantage is what, sir? Driving table. Second advantage is what, sir? Outer joins. Third advantage is what, sir? cardinality. Fourth advantage is what, sir? Fourth, what is that? Physical SQL queries to create it. Fifth is what, sir? To identify the dimension tables and fact tables. In that one, what are fourth we discussed? Physical queries, we can define it, right? I think that is the fifth point. Okay, physical queries we can create performance wise, best queries we can create. The best queries creation is possible because of what, sir? Because of logical joins. That's what I am trying to tell here. Examining logical join is an integral part of how Oracle based server figures out how to construct the physical queries. We can create the joins using this symbol, and this is what the logical diagram. Arrow mark at dimension table side are at one end. Next, logical join is used to define join relationship in the BMM layer. Allows Oracle based server to make the best decision about the exact physical SQL to generate based on the logical query path. Next one, measures. Everyone is aware of the measures, right? Let us say dollars, unit ordered, unit shipped, these all things are called as different measures. Now, are the facts of a business used to evaluate its performance? That is true or not, sir? Think about it. Yes, that's true or not, sir? Suppose any one business is running good or bad, if I given that revenue and expenditure, if I given two columns, one is expenditure, one is revenue, then you are able to decide the business is going in profit mode or loss mode. Correct or not, sir? Right. So that means whatever measures are available, measures are deciding factors of how your business is going on. Next, measures are calculations that define measurable quantities are created on logical columns in the fact table. You have a defined aggregation rule. Each and every measure compulsory contains what, sir? One defined aggregation rule it contains. Next, implementation steps. I think these are the implementation steps what we learned, right? Creating the logical business model, logical tables and logical columns, defining the logical joins, modifying the logical tables and columns, defining the measures. These are all things we have chance to understand. Creating the logical tables, columns, logical joins, advantage of the logical joins. Then we went for modifying the logical tables and columns. Renaming tables and columns, we are aware of it. Reorder the tables and columns, we are aware of it. And one more thing is here, reorder table is available, right? How to reorder the tables of the BMM layer objects, sir? I want to reorder BMM layer objects. How to reorder? Suppose I want dim one periods, I want in the second position. How to keep it? Dim one periods, I want in the second position. How to keep it? Do you have any method is available? Try to drag and drop. We'll see it. Is it going to work or not? Is it working? No. Then what to do? Try all the options, whatever you knows. Right. So there is no method to sort the things in the BMM layer. The BMM layer, table level, there is no option to provide the position of the things. But however, by default all the objects are in the descending order based on the alphabetical A to Z order. That's what dim one, whenever I give it is the first, dim two, second, dim three, second, the third line. Let us say I want this one in the first position. Then what I can do is dim three place, I can write here dim zero. Whenever I return dim zero, then automatically what is happening, sir? That is going to the first position. Suppose if I give something else here, let us say dim three I am giving, it is going towards, sir, third position. So based on the naming conventions, we can go and we can fix the position of the table. But there is no customized way of yesterday. I shown the column levels means if I double click on the table, columns means I can drag and drop wherever I want. But like this, drag and drop method is not available in case of tables. Column level I have, but I don't have what, sir? A table level I don't have, But however, we can make the A to Z order, we can make it. You got it? Next point. Add or delete tables and columns. Add or delete tables and columns. That is very simple job. You can right click and you can delete the things whenever you want. You can drag and drop whenever you want here. Next. Add or delete sources. Inside this one, whatever sources are available, if you want to add or if you want to delete, you can delete it. This one you come to understand down the line. Next, cut, copy and paste objects. Cut, copy and paste objects. Even this cut, copy and paste objects is going to work not only within the RPD, sir. I mean to say, I am creating one more business model which is known as finance. Now, let's say, anywhere you go, time dimension is common or not, sir. So, I am taking a copy. I am trying to paste here. I can paste it. Simply, I can copy and paste wherever I want. Even this copy and paste option is not only going to work within the RPD. It also going to work among RPDs also. I mean to say, suppose I am going for other batch RPD. They did a beautiful job. This one of the targets is available. I want to copy that one. Copy it. And I want to paste here. I can go here and I can paste here. Then automatically what I got, sir? B198 target DSN I got. So objects from one RPD to another RPD also you can copy and paste it. Objects from one RPD to another RPD you can copy and paste it. It's simply in MS Word, one MS Word to another MS Word you can copy and paste or not, sir? You can copy and paste. Similarly, end of the day my RPD also one file or not? End of the day my RPD also one file. That is the reason I can copy and paste from one RPD to another RPD, I can copy and paste. One of the best scenario is, down the line come to understand more points. Usage tracking is one thing is available. So that means who are the users are coming to our OBI application, what are the reports they are running. Those are all things I can track it actually. Usage tracking. Now usage tracking, RPD is a general RPD. It is common for any project. Yes or no, sir? It is common for any project. And what are reports also available, that is common for any project. Why? Because everyone is interested to see who are the users came and are running my report. What are the top 10 reports which are consuming more time in the running? Who are the top 10 users which are more time they are using my application? These are the some common questions, right? That is the reason Oracle guy, what he did is, he created reports and he created RPD, everything he created is giving as out of box. That one I want to copy and paste here in my RPD, I can copy and paste it. So my job is very simple or not, sir? Right. So that is the one best scenario what I can tell. Usage tracking scenario, we can copy and paste and we can merge the usage tracking all the tables into our original RPD. Down the line I am going to cover that one. Yes, that is clear. Let us move on to the next one. I hope you people understand what you mean by cut, copy and paste objects. Let us go for the next one. Defining the measures. Right click the logical column and select properties and select aggregation rule. Whatever aggregation rule you want, you can select that one. And I given one exercise also here. What is the exercise, sir? I want difference between first and last. I want difference. Tomorrow I can ask anyone. They need to tell without fail. At least one or two words is enough. Tell one or two words whatever you are understanding. Okay, right. Let us move on to the next one, that is called as best practices. As a BMM layer development, what are the things you need to consider as a best practices? Rename logical columns. Use names acceptable to the organization and understand by user. Users, not by developer. Business users. Whatever names you are putting in the BMM layer, that BMM layer name should be understood by business users. Next, use short names to minimize space on reports. Suppose I have one column, I given 50 characters I given. Then what will happen tomorrow, sir? Whenever I am developing my report, if I dragged a column, it is a big column name, means it is going to occupy year 2, year the space is going to occupy. Yes or no, sir? By the time two columns were drag and drop, my space is totally occupied. To reduce that one, what I am saying, sir, I am asking you to give the short names. That doesn't mean that one, you need to provide the short names in a way business user is not understanding. You need to provide the short names and also you need to keep in your mind what, sir? business user need to understand that one. Short names doesn't mean that one, to decrease the space, we are giving the name in such a way business users are not understanding means is meaningless. Next, create unique names for all columns. Unique names for all columns. What is the meaning? Suppose let us say I have RPD. Let us say I am going here. Then year column is available. One more column I am creating, new object, logical column. I am giving here. Year I am giving. Is it accepting, sir? Year is already been defined in the logical column, finance year. Okay, it is not accepting. Now I am going here. Let us say see this one. Year I have the year or not, sir? Year I have the year. It is accepting. Why, sir? This is available in different business model. This is available in different business model. But within the business model, what, sir? It is not accepting. What he is trying to tell is here. If he thinks like business user is going to confuse, at that moment, even though these are two business model, system is accepting that one. Change this name as financier. What is it, sir? Financier. This name change it as what, sir? Calendar year. It is a calendar year. It is a financier. Like that, you change it. So that business user immediately will catch up. Am I clear on it, sir? That's what he's trying to tell here. Create unique names for all columns. Avoid using the same name as logical table or business model. Don't even keep the system is going to accept it. System is going to accept it, but you don't give that names. That means table name, logical column name, business model name, all three names are giving same. System is going to accept because these all are different objects. But if you given like that, readability, understandability is going to decrease or not, sir? Is going to decrease. Next, don't delete logical columns that define the contents of logical table sources. Blindly, don't go and delete any one column, sir. Don't delete any one column that may be using in the logical table source. These are the best practices. Summary. In this lesson, you should learn. These are the things you should learn. Identify the objects of the business model and mapping layer of a repository. Build the business model. Create simple measures. Now go to the FAQs. FAQ. Are you reading FAQs also or not, sir? Yes or no? Every day you need to read the corresponding FAQs whenever I completed the chapter. And also I request you to join the site. Right. If you go for interview questions here, I think physical layer questions already we have chance to do it. Next is what, sir? Business model and mapping layer questions. What is the business model? Can we create business model like this? I have some questions are available. 11 questions are available. Try to read this all 11 questions. Am I clear? Right. Thank you. Today we understand total BMM layer. So we need to practice the hands-on. You need to follow the PowerPoint. Then you need to go for the FAQs. These are the three things what you need to finish by today, end of the day. And also you need to learn what is the meaning of first, what is the meaning of last. Am I clear? Thank you. Tomorrow, as usual, your class, sir. Okay, you may spend somewhat more hours also. Please come by 7:00. Thank you.